You see, man of God was sharing with us earlier how that they are making a plane that can move almost as fast as the speed of light from US to China. It used to be 13 hours with supersonic aircraft. Now they are beating it to matters of minutes. What does this suggest to you? Science is trying to beat time. It's trying to beat space. And it's trying to receive ability to alter the molecular structure of matter. Because they understand that the advantage the spirit realm has over us is the absence of time, space, and matter. The goal of science is to become a god of itself. And the only way it can achieve it is to beat time, is to beat space, is to beat matter. That's the advantage of the spirit realm. Science wants to become a god, but it is not given to it. You and I have a free ticket in the Holy Spirit to advance beyond everything time has to offer. By what technology did Enoch in the seventh generation after Adam to travel into rapture? It's a journey that science can never imagine. A man can enter into a reality that is many dispensations away from his time of existence. It is a technology in the Holy Spirit. The Bible says Enoch walked with God. When you walk with God, you travel faster than the fastest being and the fastest technology in time. Enoch walked with God. By what means? It was Enoch that prophesied that in the era of the Armageddon, he said the Lord will descend with 10,000 of his saints. He saw what will happen when this world is rolled away. He traveled beyond space. You can come to a point where you outsmart time. What the enemy is planning 10 years ahead, you decode it now and you change it. You see your children coming. He said he saw the names of his children. He knows how many he will give birth to. Your children will not be candidates of cancer. If they like, they will bring, they bring immunization, bring all kinds of things. You declare their destiny before they were born. You travel away from time. You travel out of space. You confound the powers of matter. You can literally change the molecular structure of things. It is by alignment with the Holy Spirit. These matters are deeper than doctrine. You can know all the doctrine, but you will be as weak and you will be a puppet in the hands of the devil. They are not matters of doctrine. They are realities. If everyone will synchronize with the Holy Spirit, I assure you, it's enough. It's enough. The reason we hear all the teaching but nothing changes is because there is no commitment to the Holy Ghost. Spirits begin to walk from where you make commitment. It is your commitment that opened the door for the workings of spirits. Consciously in your heart, make a decision. Make a decision. And you will save yourself from the plague of mortality. People go, before they read the course, they try to check the one that is more advantageous. And then they kill themselves to read that course. Parents try to model the lives of their children. Bring home teachers, bring this to force them into this, because all their calculations is in the natural. Men give bribes to go into jobs that has nothing to do with the ordination. We don't seek jobs. We are sent into all the wars. If you find him in the army, he was sent there to better dimension. We don't look for jobs because we are not sustained by mortal men. We are not sustained by the wisdom of man. We are sustained by the powers that hold all things together. Did you not hear when he said, cast thy bread upon the waters? He said, you will find it after many days. Let me tell you what he's saying. God gives you seed to sow. Bread is what you should eat. He said, but there is a place you come in trust where you can cast even what he gave you to eat. He said, you don't know the evil that will come upon the earth. Give a portion to seven, give a portion to eight. Why? Even if the whole earth were to melt, you will survive. Because you are powered by a force that is deeper than everything in time. Can a believer looking for job, try this, try that, try that. It shows that you don't hear from the spiritual. When you begin to hear, you will journey into your inheritance. Sons don't wonder. We walk in pursuit of inheritance. When Abraham left his father's house, left his kindred, left his nation, he was not going to look for bread and green pasture. He was in search of inheritance. The Bible said he was looking for a city with a foundation whose builder is God. That's what drives us around. Not relocating to Abuja because they say it's a federal capital territory. You are going there because there's a window you have to open so that the dimension in God can begin to find expression. How you will survive is not part of your equation. That one is for him to answer. And you have journeyed with him in trust to a level where you can trust. That's why Elijah can come into the territory and say, before God whom I stand, there shall be no rain. And as he left, the spirit guided his step into a brook. He sat there. The ravens came to give him bread in the morning and the evening. Scientific research shows that the most stingy kinds of bird are ravens. When the water dried up, he said, arise now, go to Zarephath. I have prepared a widow to feed you. You are here wasting all your time trying to do all the arithmetic on how you will get a job with Chevron. We are far from the spirit. We are far. Pastors even advise people, oh boy, try help yourself. You hear things like heaven helps those who help themselves. Have you utilized all the wisdom in scriptures? It's a pity. It's a pity. It's a pity. Ask the Lord to help you. Make conscious decisions. Make conscious decisions. When I began to grow in God, I realized that every man has a message locked up in his spirit. We are not called to preach all the Bible. Everybody has a dimension of Jesus as a message locked up in his spirit. When the Holy Ghost begins to open you up, the passages of scriptures will help you give expression to those messages. And that is why God will send you to definite strategic people and places where your message will be relevant. Those will be the things that will inspire your sojourning on the face of the earth. And you ask the Lord consciously, consciously, consciously. Some of us have gone for meetings, many meetings. I tell you, many meetings. Until we discover that every other thing will begin to make sense when we have apprehended the Holy Spirit. When we have choose the Holy, until you come to a point where you choose the Holy Ghost, nothing will make meaning. I went to Randy Clark's meeting in Lagos. I knelt before him. He laid hands on me and said, you will walk in the glory realm. I have ministered in places where white clouds came into the building and people began to scream. I have seen the Shekinah with my tangible eyes. He said, you will walk in the glory. But all those things never came to pass until I chose the Holy Spirit. Sometimes you think, when I'm tired and I'm sleeping, he comes and he beckons on me to pray. And I pray for 3 hours and I don't sense anything. Because it's not coming to wake you to sense something. That time when you are praying, maybe you are giving vocabulary to a life somewhere. Armed robbers have invaded the house. They are about to rape some virgins. He woke you up so that you can shut that protocol. That time you are praying, enchantments are going up so that demons can be invoked into territories. When you stood up as a custodian. You are shutting the gates of darkness. So it's not about feeling. There are tangible economies in God. Legislating policies in the spirit. Things are deep things. That's why I told you that spirit don't measure realities in time. They measure by life. Come, you say you are 30 years in the Lord. They don't know that thing. What measure of life have you given expression to? Those are the economies that spirit judge realities by. Can you ask the Lord that you are committed? You are committed. I stood before Benihim. He released the anointing upon me. Nothing manifested in my life. I have met Todd White. Todd White is a street evangelist. He holds people's leg and pull it out. It grows on the street. It's not a church where people know about God and then people are trying to encourage you. He goes to meet tongues. Some of them are smoking while he's praying for them. They are healed. A rugged street evangelist. He held me. He said, what I have, take it. I saw nothing. I met all of these men. Randy Clark is the man that wrote a foreword in the School of the Seers. He's one of the most notable apostles in the U.S. I stood before Sadhu Savaraj an Indian prophet. Sadhu Savaraj, every scripture he has read, the writer of that book comes to meet him. He was reading the book of Isaiah. And then the prophet showed up. People walk out of the wall and meet him. He has met with Paul and asked questions. What does this scripture mean? He was studying the book of Revelation. He couldn't understand what Revelation 13 was talking about. About the abomination of desolation. And then he began to pray. And John walked into the room and told him this is what it means. Daniel spoke about it. It's here now. These are the people that will bring it to pass. Those are the kind of people I spoke about. I knelt down before him, he imparted me, but it translated to nothing. Dr. Paul, an angel, have anointed my head. Bishop David Oedeku have prayed for me. I stood before Christ, Reverend Christ will kill me. He imparted me with the hidden anointing. I have pursued the anointing. When I went for passing on the torch in Lagos, I slept on the crusade ground, praying in tongues every night so that something will rest. But it dawned on me that even if they pour a drum of oil on you, if you don't choose the Holy Ghost and walk with him, all of them will be seeds and potentials. They will never come to pass. They will never come to pass. I have met the finest of preachers, the finest, and they have laid their hands on me, the finest. Apostle Arome have laid hands on me, giving me garments. He said, you are the one, everything I have in God, you will have it, and you will manifest brighter lights of it. He said, that's what God told me. He said, God told me, raise a company of 12 apostles that will steward the revival to the ends of the earth. He said, you are the first. But it will not translate to anything except as you submit your will to the Holy Ghost. That's when walk with God moves from emotion into a conscious reality. Everything they taught you in church is how to follow the reading. That's a lie. It won't lead anywhere. I experimented it myself. I've met everybody you know has manifestation. And when you have met Benihim to impart you, you have met half of the preachers in the world. Because in this current dispensation, there are few people that have interacted with preachers like Benihim. But it doesn't amount to anything. You may fall under the atmosphere, enjoy the euphoria. You go back and be nothing. Just like Judas lived with Jesus all his life, but he ended up as the son of perdition. It will mean nothing. If your will is not submitted to the will of the Holy Spirit, you will be nothing. Jesus was the one that showed us the protocol. He said, it is written in the volume of the books, I come to do thy will. When he came to Gethsemane, it became too heavy. But he fell upon his knees and he said, not my will, but thy will. That's the gate into reality. That's the gate into power. That's the gate into relevance. You may do everything that there is to do in the body of Christ. If you are disaligned, you will be nowhere. The men that are mighty in God, they are not men of talk. They are not men of activity. They are men of alignment. They are men of obedience. They are men of faith.